your home sweet home a former meth lab? We learned it's not easy to find out. Why? Because your lawmakers made it that way. 4029's John Paul explains why and what you can do to get around it. It's a story you'll only see on 4029.
The key ingredient you'd find in cough medicine. Batteries. Drain cleaner. And add a little paint thinner for good measure. It's a hazardous combination better known as meth. Boy, oh boy, is it lethal.
Inhaling it, breathing it, touching it, any number of these things are just not meant to be in contact with the human body.
The chemical's harmful effects can linger wherever methamphetamines were cooked. Arkansas lawmakers passed a law in 2008 to track meth labs. Investigators bust the labs, then Arkansas's Department of Environmental Quality tracks the contaminated properties. We found more than 20 pages of records, about 967 busted labs since 2008, all categorized by year, county, city, and street. One thing you won't find, a record of the 200 former labs that were decontaminated by a state-approved cleaning contractor. After those properties are posted here, it's taken down after 10 days.
It's written into state law that once that 10 days is up, if it has been cleaned, those records are gone.
Never to be seen again. Is this a case where they don't want you to know? ADEQ says that's not the case.
If it's not on that list, it's not contaminated.
Catherine Beninati said ADEQ does not track clean properties. So what does that mean? Unless your landlord or realtor tells you about your home's history, you'll never know. 4029 News found a public records request with local police departments for a list of properties investigated for meth activity since 2008. We went door to door in Washington County to ask people if their landlord told them about their once contaminated property.
And we were wondering if you rented or owned this place and if you had any idea.
I had no idea.
How long have you lived here?
Since December.
Did anybody tell you when you rented it out or anything like that?
No, the owners don't even live in town.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they're like out in Elkin somewhere. I found it on Craigslist.
Okay.
And there's a good reason why the landlord never told their tenant. They don't have to. To get removed from the list, a property owner has to pay a contractor between $4,000 and $10,000 to clean their contaminated property. The lowest acceptable standard is 0.5 milligrams per 100 centimeters. So small, you can't even see it with the naked eye. Once it's inspected and cleared, as far as the law is concerned, it's a non-contaminated property.
In talking with those who do these cleanups, I think what they essentially told us and what we eventually agreed to do was, once that property is cleaned and certified by them, that it is probably cleaner than most houses in the neighborhood because they have to go and scrub down everything, every fixture.
4029 News went to Little Rock to talk to Shane Broadway. He's a former state senator who created the meth cleanup law. One of the reasons you won't be able to find decontaminated properties after 10 days is because of the way the law was written, which protects the property from being tainted.
That was probably the toughest issue we grappled with, because you're trying to weigh the balance of ensuring the consumer's protected, but also ensuring that someone's investment is not forever tainted, that they'll never be able to, you know, to let it go.
We filed a public records request for backup files and server records. The ADEQ director said forms are never kept in a database. All documentation is deleted from his personal computer. They told us to look at the law. We did. While we could not find anything specifically in Act 864 that decontaminated site records should be destroyed, our Freedom of Information Act expert told us, under FOIA, they do not have to provide records that do not exist. But given the fact most are electronic, it's hard to imagine they cannot retrieve most documents. There's no provision for destruction of documents under FOIA, but it is recognized that documents do not have to be retained forever. As for tenants like this woman,
what's kind of going through your mind right now?
Well, I hear that stuff sticks in the paint and stuff. That kind of worries me. I signed a year lease. I'm kind of stuck now.
Okay. I mean, even if it's not on the contaminated list but was a former meth lab, does that make you nervous at all still?
A little bit.
I'm John Paul reporting. 4029 News.
That's a scary thought. 4029 News also talked to realtors. One told us the only way a buyer would know if a home was a meth lab is to have an inspection completed. The ADEQ said if you have any questions about a property, call your local police department to find out if they investigated that address in question. And for a list of additional homes gathered in our investigation, you can click through the slideshow in the feature section of 4029tv.com.